Welcome to the Jamerson Family YMCA. We're going to try some yoga today. Today is going to be more about a little bit of power, so we're going to try to work on some strength. Of course, if you're doing this video, make sure you're a little bit warmer when we get started. Let those shoulders relax down the back. We're going to breathe in through the nose, taking long breath out through the nose. Each inhale, we try to round the belly and see if we can expand the rib cage, and we're lifting up into the collarbones. Each exhale, we push all of the air out and take that navel into spine. So we try to work with the breath as much as we can. Let those hands come down beside us, and we take a deep inhale, arms up and overhead. When we exhale, let the hands come down. So like I said, this is going to be power, so let's get some movement going. Take it around and come up to all fours. And then we tuck our toes and immediately lift up into down dog. So we've got a nice upside down V going on here. Trying to keep the arms long, and we don't want to cave between the shoulders. We want to lift up through the armpits. Trying to press the hips back. Heels are working down toward the mat. No, that does not mean you have to stretch yourself silly trying to get those heels down. Take a deep inhale, come all the way forward, getting into a nice plank pose. So we want shoulders and wrists lined up. Try to roll the shoulders down and then see if we can lift up through the shoulder blades to help protect our shoulders. We always want to keep that gaze out and down to keep us from dropping and straining the neck. Tuck that tailbone under, navel is in, and then we take the heels push back. So when we are correctly in a plank pose, we will feel it from head to toe, which is a fabulous feeling. Get those elbows and squeeze them in. It's a little different than group fitness because we don't take the elbows out. We squeeze in and try to exhale, lower down. We call it chaturanga. So we're holding right above the mat, making sure that tailbone is tucked, and we push the heels to the back wall. Keep that nice straight line. Then we flip one foot under and the other, and we push up into an up dog, letting those hips drop down. Chest is lifted, maybe lift the chin, get that nice arch to the back. Navel in, exhale, go all the way back into our down dog. So let's change that little half series we just did. We take a deep inhale, come all the way up onto the toes. We're going to round the back and come forward. It's like we're rolling. Navel is pulling in, so we've got that nice arch to the back. And when we exhale, ease forward, back into that plank pose. Always do a body scan. Make sure we're in correct position. And then when we exhale, come down to our chaturanga. Notice we're looking out and down to keep that body straight, tailbone tucked to protect the back. When we flip the foot this time and the other, take a little pause here. So we inhale, push up, get into that up dog, and then I want us to lift the hips up. So we're doing like a reverse plank here. Now navel in, exhale, take it all the way back, downward facing dog. And if we push left heel down and slightly bend the right knee, keeping the arms long, we're gonna get that stretch in the back of that left hamstring. Try to focus on that hamstring and keep those arms long. Then we take the hips and shift them to the left just slightly so we can change that stretch. We try to hold most stretches about 20 seconds. Now switch to the other side. Right heel pushes down. Left knee has a slight bend. We might feel it along the calf, the back of the knee, the hamstring, maybe have a little glute awareness here. And then we can ease into that right hip. That might take it to that outer thigh a little bit. Keep those arms stretched out long. We have a tendency to come forward here and we don't want to do that. Now both heels press. So we have an option to look forward. And we want to take one big step, maybe we take a bunch of little steps, or we bend the knees and take a little hop, coming into forward fold. Always put a bend to those knees. It protects the hamstrings, protects our back, and then we take the hands, lift the shins, shoulders roll down the back, top of the head, push it forward. We're trying to keep this nice long L shape. Get those shoulders down. When we take the head and push forward, the heels are going to stay down, but the weight will come forward into the toes a little bit, and that deepens that stretch in the back of the legs. Exhaling, go back into our float. Both arms inhaling up and overhead. And when we exhale, push hips back, take arms out in front. First thing we need to do when we get into a chair pose, it's a squat. So we want those toes to come up and give them a little wiggle. Take your tailbone, tuck it under. That does two things. It will straighten out the spine and protect the back, but then it fires up those quads. So we want those shoulders down the back. And we inhale, take the arms up and overhead. And we exhale, bring hands to heart center. Hopefully that gave us a little warm up, and I hope to see you soon. Namaste.